and I hope to release it on itch.io today. So let's just see what we have so far. We have this game here. And so far, what's lacking is a start screen where the user can get the instructions. I think I'm gonna put it like right at the center here. I'm gonna put like, you have to move up, down, left, right. I'm not gonna tell them about the field of vision. They'll find out for themselves, but I'm just gonna say you have to do up, down, left, right, press space bar to begin. And once you die, the same, you'll reload to the same starting screen again. Okay, so let's try to code that. So for this, okay, we'll need to actually, just you see my head, all this is already there in the scene itself. If you look closely, we need to sort of remove this head and only like put it in the game after the user press enter. So we need to set this game object as inactive first before Yeah, we need to set it as inactive first before we can, like after you press the space bar, then it becomes active. So the other thing we want to do is we want to have another canvas that displays the, we want to display the text here in right at the center. Okay, so for that we probably need another canvas. Okay, let's just create another canvas. UI canvas. I mean, I can do UI text or so, a new canvas. Oh no, no, no. Actually, I can use the same canvas. I just need to hide that. Yeah, actually, why not? Yeah, I mean, we might as well just use the same canvas. And over here, I just expand the width and the height. Maybe width 300, height is 300. It could be a bit bigger, like that. Yeah, and over here, we can have some text, like move. By using the arrow keys. I think arrow keys is sufficient. I mean, I believe they know what's up, down, left, right. Move by using the arrow keys. Press space to start. Okay, then here we put best fit. Okay, we want it to be white because the background is dark blue. Okay, we have this and the font, we want to use that snakey font. Yeah. Okay, let's see how it looks like visually. Yeah, so I want to remove this head. Okay, so in the game manager, I want to add two things. Let's go to our script. In the game manager, okay. In the game manager, I like to add two public variables now. Okay, so one public variable that I'm going to add is I'm going to add the text, which is called instruction text, which is the text that will be shown at the beginning. And then I also want to have another public game object. Actually, that will be the head, but yeah, we didn't call it game object. Okay, snake. Let's just call it snake. Okay, so on starts, okay. When we first start the game, okay, we shouldn't do all this score equals zero. This one maybe is, we can call it in the public start game method, public void start game method. So in start game, then we do all this. Okay, so we don't do it right at the start. Okay, so in update, if input.getKeyDown keycode.space. Okay, if user press the space bar, then start the game. Okay, so we do this is input.getKeyDown keycode.space, and we do the start game code here. Okay, so in the start game code, we also would like to set the snake to be active. So we have this snake prefab snake dot set active to be true. Okay, and then set the instruction text to be inactive. So instruction text.setActive false. I'm not sure whether I need to do the game object of this, but we can try this first. If it fails, then yeah. So in the beginning here, we will also need to, the score can remain. I mean, I don't see that why we need the score. So we can set the snake to be inactive at the beginning, and then set the instruction text to be active. Yeah, so if the snake is inactive, no matter when you press up, down, left, right, it shouldn't affect anything. Okay, and we only will generate the food once we start the game. And yeah, once you die, you have 3 seconds to see the death state, and then the game will restart. So that looks good to me. I just want the game to be on one single scene. Yeah, it's a simple game and it should have a simple interface. Yeah, okay, so this is done. Okay, let's see whether there's any errors. Usually when you code stuff, there should be some errors. I mean, I'm always going with the mentality that there will be errors. Text does not contain a set active. Yeah, so I suspected that. So it means that I have to, instead of the text, we have to reference the game object of that text. Yeah, you can only set active to the game object itself. So let's save this and then we see whether there's any more. Let me just check my Twitch stream. Okay, yeah, it's active. Okay, so let's go here and add to the game manager. So we can apply this override. Okay, we need to set the instruction text over here and the snake head itself to be here. Yeah, let's just call this the instruction text. Okay, so this is how it should look like. Let's run it and see how it goes. Very nice. Okay, there's a problem here. The score is 2. It shouldn't be 2. It should be 0. So you see, the score is not updated to be 0, and that's because I took away the score equals 0 here. Let's just put it back. Let's put it back. And we also like the display score to be here, so all this can remain. We just generate the food. So this will begin the game by generating the first apple, the first food. Okay, let's try this now. Yeah, I'm thinking actually I will want to have 2 background sounds now. One background music will be for the normal ones. But over here, before the thing starts, maybe we can have a different music. Just to, you know, separate the resting screen and the load and the game screen. Yeah. I'm thinking whether I want to have like a little circle on the snake to represent the eyes, or 2 circles to represent the eyes. That'll be quite cute, right? Okay, now my score is like that. Okay, I should restart to the beginning again. Very nice. So now if I press my arrow keys, which I'm doing right now, it's not moving, so only when I press space, yes, then it starts. Okay. Let's pick a new background sound for the waiting page. Yeah, so the waiting page will have another BGX that is a bit more gentle, a bit more soothing. It's like the relaxing one. So maybe we go with nature. I mean, nature sounds soothing, right? Yeah. Hi, Godet Sava. How's your day today? Oh, that's good. Is your course doing well? The new part? I mean, after my part. Yeah, I did. Yeah, today was a relaxing day for me. I'm very happy right now that like this snake game is about to finish. Yeah, it's always good to publish a game. Oh, that's good, that's good. Actually, this is quite relaxing music. Maybe Hidden Pawn might be better. Distant Mountains. Oh, it's about 9:37 for me. I'm GMT plus 8. Nope, this is a bit too much. Ah, this one might be good. Life in the drop. Oh, but there's a period of silence. That's not very good. Lost Meadow. I like this kind of mystery feeling. Well, actually, this is not bad for a starting screen. It's either this or Ocean Floor. Let's try Ocean Floor. Okay, I think Lost Middle sounds nicer. Okay, let's download this. Save link as Lost Middle. Okay, so actually, if I download all this, I am actually supposed to cite Eric Mathias, Mathias in the game. So later, I'll just do like maybe a cite by here, music by who. Yeah, so we can do that. That's his only request when we use his music, which I think is a fair request. I mean, he probably spent quite a lot of effort and time making all these sounds, which I quite like. So most of my games actually use his sounds. His sounds are so-so, I mean the UI sounds and everything, but his background music stuff is not bad. Okay, so this one is introduction. So, okay, in the music sound manager, okay, we don't really have this music. So this one is, maybe we don't call this music anymore. We call this game music or action music. Let's label this action music. And then we put in this introduction, and then we just label this introduction music. Okay, so in the action music, let's not play on awake anymore. We'll still loop it, but we will not play on awake. Okay, I will need to go to my game manager file in scripts game manager. No, wrong one, sound manager. Okay, so now we have play. We have another function called play background. Okay, and then we also have a sound num. And then same thing over here actually. We just change here to maybe backgrounds.com. So here will be backgrounds. Okay, one thing over here is we want to stop all background sounds. So over here, we can just look through for int I equals 0, I smaller equals 2. Or I mean, you can also do the auto method. Like this for auto, background, in backgrounds. This is the, I think it's for each. For each, I can't really remember it for C sharp. It's either a for or for each. It's a for each. Okay, in C sharp. We can do background dot stop. Okay, let's just search for audio source stop unity. So I believe the command is audio source dot stop. Yeah, we don't want to pause it because we don't want to restart from that. We can just audio source background dot stop, and then for that particular sound, we'll play. Okay, so that's how we will do it. Okay, and then over here we will need another list of audio source called backgrounds. Okay, as simple as that. So let's do it in our sound manager. Okay, that's an issue right now. Auto could not be found. Okay, auto is a C++ term. It's actually called var in C sharp. Yeah, so let's change it to var. Variable, var for variable. It's actually one of the cool things about C sharp, auto typing. Although in Python it's automatic auto typing, at least in C sharp we have auto typing like this. We can save a lot of effort typing it out. And actually the runtime speed is the same actually, because they will actually interpret your auto and convert it to the right class or a right data type first before the thing is compiled, before the program is compiled. Okay, so over here in backgrounds, okay, we have nothing yet. So under sound manager, we have all this. Okay, we can actually put all this introduction music and action music inside here. We can actually do like two things, like sound and background. We can do a subfolder here by having another game object as a parent. But I'm skipping that because we have very few sounds. That doesn't really make much sense to need to do it. Okay, so over here in this backgrounds, we just make the size 2 and we put in the introduction music and the action music. So guess who is going to control this music? All right, if your guess is the game manager, you're right. Everything should be controlled by the game manager. Okay, if as far as possible. So the game manager should do this. How long do I take to make a game? It depends on the type of game. The longest I spent creating a game was my card game. I was doing like a trading card game. It's called Attack or Defend. It's on my Simmer page, simmer.io. That took me 1 month. Okay, because the gameplay mechanics took a while to code. The AI took a while to refine. Yeah. But usually I will take about 1 to 2 weeks to code my games. Like my platformer, I took about 2 weeks. My Breakbuster, I took about 2 weeks. Yeah. I like to do games fast, because I find that if you take too long to finish a game, you might lose the motivation. Yeah, so especially for indie projects, it's not good to drag too long. Yeah, because the moment you drag too long, you might get occupied with other things. And then, you know, you might get occupied with other things and you won't even finish the game. So yeah, it's very important to finish what you start, because if not, you wouldn't have the motivation to do more. Yeah, it's like, you know, you spend like maybe a few weeks doing a game and then you just end there without finishing your game. You can't show anyone what you've done. It's kind of sad, isn't it? Yeah, so we should aim to finish the game soon. I mean, even if it's like a trial version or what, you should just do it first. Maybe seek some feedback. Then if you want or you have the motivation to develop some more, then you do some more. Yeah, but I don't think it's a good idea to just say like, oh, I'll spend 1 year on this game, when actually you can complete it faster. Yeah. So that's my take on it. Okay, so now I want to play the sound at the beginning. So when we start here, okay, we want to play the introduction sound. So how do we do this? Okay, so where's our music manager? Okay, so we do have a sound manager here. Okay, this sound manager. Okay, where's my variable for sound manager? Somewhere here, right? Sound manager. Oh, I put it as public, which actually shouldn't be the case. Because I actually find so it should be private actually. But no biggie. I mean, even in game manager, I put here none, that's fine also. So my sound manager, it doesn't need to be public because I actually find the sound manager already. Okay, so how do we get the introduction sound to play? In Sound Manager, remember we have this function here, stop play background. So let's do that. SoundManager.playBackground. And then this is soundtrack 0. Because if we go to our Sound Manager, okay, it's lagging a bit. Hi, the best. Yeah, so over here, Sound Manager, we do have two background music set. 0 is the introduction, so let's do 0. So we play background 0. Where was that line? Oh no, I went all the way to the bottom. It's actually here. Yeah, there we go. Play the introduction sound. So I'm just going to copy this and paste it at start game. So over here, we want to play the action sound. So we can do it at 1. Yeah, so I think there's no need to have a death sound or death soundtrack, because the death part, we're only going to show the freeze the screen for 3 seconds. That's like kind of weird to change a new sound. So I think it's okay to just have 2 themes. Okay, let's try it. Oh, that sounds good. That sounds good. Okay, this one shouldn't be pre-aspect. It should be 960 by 600. This will be the size for our WebGL build when we publish the game. Okay, so this is how it looks like now. Press space to start. Yeah. I like this music. It's the suspense. Okay, so we should have very nice. Okay, so I think this game is good already. Okay, this game is good already. As of now, I think it's good enough. Okay, I do have some ideas for like a hard mode in this game. In my games, I do like to have this hard mode thing. I'm going to publish this on itch.io. Yes, I'm going to show you how to publish it. Yeah, that's so maybe tomorrow I'll do my hard mode for this game. So give you a little teaser for hard mode. It's going to be never ending. So I will want to have a stream where I will have a global high score table. So maybe at the bottom here, I'll have a button called high scores. Then you will load the high score. When you click on high score, you go to another page where you have all the top scorers and you can see how well you fare globally. Yeah, I intend to do that. So that will require some Firebase integration. So that one will be for another stream. I think that one needs about 1 to 2 hours. Yeah, I haven't really done it before. I know that you can do it. And yeah, I'm going to try to do it because I think it makes it more fun for you to like compare your high score. Okay. And another thing that I want to do is if you get above like 50 points, I think I will have a hard mode here button come up. So a hard mode button, that's a teaser. If you think this mode is hard, then you'll be mistaken, because actually I have thought of some ideas to make it even harder. Okay, and the idea is instead of 1 snake, you control 2 snakes. Sounds fun. It's multitasking to the extreme. Yeah, so stay tuned for that if you want to see how hard mode snake is going to be. So I'm thinking how I visualize it is that there will be 1 grid here on the left and another grid here on the right. And then you start by controlling 2 snakes, but the apple positions and the bad apple positions are all going to be random, you see, for each left and right grid. So they're all going to be different. But you need to control both snakes to eat apples. And if any snake dies, you lose the game. Yeah, so that's going to be hard mode for snake-like. I think maybe 2 to 3 days. Depends on how long the hard mode takes to code. Yeah, but I'm going to publish this game first. Okay, I think this game is good already. So let's publish it first. Okay, let's build and run. build settings maybe. Okay, we go over to WebGL. Okay, let's switch platform. Okay, we want to switch to WebGL. No, there's no levels for this. Yeah, I'm a bit lazy to do levels. I'm just gonna have hard mode and normal mode. Yeah. Hard mode is for people who want to challenge themselves. But in order to unlock hard mode, you need to score like 50 points on normal mode. So hard mode will only be unlocked if you are good enough. If you are not good enough, I'm not gonna overwhelm you with hard mode. But you know, if you are quite good in this game, then why not? Something to challenge the better gamers. I always like to have this kind of like I call it Easter eggs in my games, like so that you know you feel a sort of challenge. Like you know, in my Breakbuster, the expedition mode was meant to be like an Easter egg, because the puzzle mode is meant to be solvable by everyone. But the expedition, I can tell you, out of 50 friends who played my game, I think only about 3 people completed all 100 levels for expedition. So and the levels are randomly generated, so there's no way you can like you can memorize a sequence of steps. Yeah, so yeah, my games are not easy. But that's the fun of being a game creator, you see. You get to dictate how hard you want your game to be. You get to design levels. Yeah. You get to create the stuff that you have in your head. And that's why I like to do this kind of game dev. Yeah, it brings out your creativity. Yeah. I find that like education system is kind of what do you call that? Restricted. You just follow a model answer, model textbook. Yeah, we don't really like exercise our creativity much. And yeah, I find that you can exercise a lot of creativity when you design your own games. I mean, it's just one avenue and I like it. Yeah, so yeah. Okay, now it's at WebGL. Let's see how it looks like. Very nice, very nice. Okay, let's go build settings. Okay, we go build settings and we click on this player settings just to take a look at what we have here for player settings. Okay, I want it to be outside. I guess this is fine as well. So in WebGL, 960 by 600, okay. I'm not gonna put any icon, doesn't matter. Splash image, don't need. Okay, we are not gonna exactly upload on mobile phone, but if you are doing mobile phone, then you know, all these icons will affect how it looks like in Play Store. So, wait, actually, no. Play Store, they actually have another web page for you to configure all this. So actually, all these are not very crucial. This is going to affect probably only how the icon appears on your phone. Yeah, so you might want to add an image here if you are doing for mobile phone development. So in other settings, all these don't need to change. Okay, all these are okay. The only thing we need to care about, all these are all right. The default is okay. The only thing we need to care about is we can do gzip or disable. Okay, so some people would like, if you do cinema.io, they want it to be disabled. But I think we can try gzip first, okay, and see whether this is the compression. So the more compressed it is, I think the better it is. But some editors online, I mean some publishers online, they don't really allow it. Okay, so let's build and run. So we can save it as snake and we can call it WebGL build. Save this. Yeah, so this is we're gonna build it. We're gonna put it online and it'd be cool, you know. I mean, if you want to even enhance the game further, you can have an options menu where you can adjust the volume settings of the game. But I'm just gonna skip it for this one because I don't think it matters a lot. People can just tune the volume on their computers. I'm not gonna create a button for the volume settings. Although I did create such a button in my other games. Yeah. But this snake game is designed to be simple, and I don't want to overcomplicate the UI. Oh, we just wait a while for I mean, meanwhile, if you have anything you want to ask, you can go ahead, like regarding game dev or coding in general. I'm happy to answer them if I can. Oh, no, that's not fruit juice. I mean, I shouldn't be drinking this, but this one is at night, but this is oolong tea. Okay, see it? Yeah. Tea doesn't have any effect on me in terms of not being able to sleep. Yeah, although I do drink fruit juice as well. Do I use VSC? I'm not sure what is VSC. You have to tell me. Yeah. Okay, I'm not sure why it's taking so long, but it is definitely taking a while. So we just have to wait. Yeah. I guess it's going to start soon. We might as well just go to our itch.io and start typing our stuff inside. So this one would be called Snake Lights. Yeah, project URL snake light. Short description. Control a snake in darkness. Try to survive as long as possible. What are you uploading? Games. Kind of project. HTML. Release status is released. Okay. Pricing is zero or donate. Okay, if people want to donate, they can donate. Add a zip file containing your game. Oh, I forgot to put Eric Matters as part of my game credits. It's okay. In my new upload, I'll put it. Oh, yeah. I do use Visual Studio Code. It is actually one of my best IDEs. I mean, I like it a lot because in the IDE itself, you can download all these extensions. Let me show you. File extensions. Oh no, where was it? Extensions. Yeah, now it's blocked, but you can see in extensions, you can download stuff like Python, Ruby, C++, C#. Yeah, so essentially you don't have to install anything in your computer. You just download this extension, it can compile for you already. So the interface will be exactly the same here. You just need to change your file name tag, download the extension, and then you just click this play button at the top. This play button here, you can run that code in that language. And you know, all you need is just a video with extensions. If you're talking about Steam, I don't know how to do it. And besides, my game is, it's not exactly the very AAA kind of games. I'm still a newbie here, you see, at game creation. I'm doing like 2D simple graphics games. Am I on Discord? I do not have a private Discord at the moment, but I do have a Discord ID. Yeah. Now, who knows? I mean, I might have a Discord link next time. If enough people want to chat with me about games, we could have a private Discord server talking about it. Yeah, I'll keep you updated if I do create a Discord server. But as of now, I'm only on Discord. Okay, so this is, it looks a bit big actually, right? It's supposed to be 960 by 600. Yeah, now it looks slightly bigger than what I intended it to be. Okay, so 960 by 600 supposed to look like this. It's supposed to look like this. I mean, that's why I created it as 900 by 600. Sorry, 960 by 600. I want this to be slightly bigger. Oh, you mean download this game? I haven't uploaded it yet, but once I upload, I'll put the link in my chat and you can go and download it from there. Okay, so right now I want to go to my Finder. Okay, we go to John Tan Chong Ming, and over here, no, I think it's under John's MacBook users, because I remember my snake was like in a meta folder up here. Yep, it's here. So we have a WebGL build. I need to compress it to a zip file. Okay, so very important to check whether you have this index.html. Oh, the high score will be a local high score right now, because I have not set up a Firebase to keep track of everyone's high score yet. So I will need to write a script to send your high score to this Firebase. Firebase is an online data server. And then like you can also retrieve the entries from the Firebase in order to find out what's your rank globally. Yeah, so as of now, the high score is limited only to your computer. But very soon it will be a global high score, don't worry. I still intend to edit the game a bit more. I just want to upload the game so that you know you all can try it and give some feedback if you want to. Okay, so so this will be 640 by 960 by 600. 960 by 600. I want it to be mobile friendly. Oh, wait, actually, they can't really play the game on mobile, can they? Yeah, I need to create some buttons here because up, down, left, right can only work on computers. Yeah, so if I want to do a mobile friendly version, I need to have some buttons here to say up, down, left, right, and they can click on the buttons accordingly. That could be an add on here. We could do 4 buttons and so that, you know, press space slash click to start. So once you click over here, they are able to start the game. Yeah, we could do that. But never mind, as of now, I'll just limit it to, yeah, let's not put mobile friendly, it's meant to be for computers. Is it possible for you to make a basic first person shooter? You're talking about 3D, then I'm not able to do that yet. I'm still learning how to do Unity 3D. So once I learn it, then maybe we could do a first-person shooter. But the problem with creating 3D games, I feel, is that the art assets are quite hard to create. You need to partner with someone who can create those like visually stunning 3D graphics, which will be much easier to do in 2D, because you can just use pixel art or paint to do it yourself. In 3D, you have to use software like Blender, which to me just increases the amount of time that will take to make a game. And you know, because I'm here for the mainly for the gameplay in terms of the experience of the gameplay in terms of strategy. I mean, my games are mainly strategy games. I tend to avoid 3D because I feel that if I can do it in 2D already, why should I use the extra time to make it 3D? I mean, that's just my thinking, but I'm actually learning Unity 3D now. 2D first person shooter, you mean talking about? Like Metal Slug? That's not really first person shooter, but you know, shoot from the side. Yeah, I know how to do stuff like Metal Slug. Yeah. Yeah, but that will take weeks to program though, because you need to create the enemies one by one. Yeah. Alright, let's try to finish this first. Automatically start on page load. No, actually I think we could do it because it's like press space to start, so it's okay. Full screen button don't need because Unity will already have one. Enable scroll bars, no. Okay, description. Didn't I put the description here already? Okay, let's put it again. Controls, arrow keys, move the snake. Oh, but the next game I'll be creating will be the T-Rex run, as suggested by the best. Yeah, I think that will be a good next game to go to just show people how to do motion and colliders. Yeah, I'll do T-Rex run next. Re-implementation of T-Rex run. I think that will be my next game after the snake lights. Okay, space bar will be start again. Okay, so select the category, action. Action or strategy, puzzle, survive. Could be survival also. But I think maybe survival. pixel art, adventure, platformer, survival, puzzle, strategy. Yeah, I like to put strategy. Oh, I like to do a rhythm game sometime as well. Yeah, it's been on my mind also. So let's see. So many texts. I wonder who created it. Oh, bullet hell is fun as well, like creating a Toho. But that requires quite a lot of effort. Because I realized like bullet dynamics look kind of meh if you don't really like create the proper angles and everything. When they do Toho, they actually experimented with different angles, different projectile types, spinning types, boomerang types. It's pretty amazing how they actually created it. I think it's only one guy who created the Toho shooting games. Okay, so here, I think it's fine. Let's just put it as strategy. Custom noun, don't need comments. Okay, no problem. Draft. Okay, let's save and view page. Right, did I put the no file provided back? Okay, we should put this. Did they just restart everything that I typed? Okay, let's upload files. Okay, where was my file? It was here. Upload files. Okay, I guess we have to go to snake ourselves, WebGL build. Nah, I don't want to set a price for this file. This file will be split. Let's just hide this file and prevent it from being downloaded. I don't know, set a... You mean people will actually pay for the file? This file will be played in the browser. Yeah, let's just do that. Yeah. I don't want to like... No, this game was coded in C#. But there's another engine called Godot, G-O-D-O-T, that is created in Python. Save. Oh, I need to upload a cover image. Okay, let's get ourselves some cover image. Okay, let's get some cover image for this. Okay, this is gonna be one cover image. Like that. This will be one image. I'll need to make the snake a bit longer, so that I get some attractive and juicy images to entice people to play this game. Yeah, it's all about marketing here. Yeah, marketing the game. It is cheap. Once the apple appear on the bad apple, actually it removes the bad apple. I decided to keep it as a feature because I think people appreciate fewer bad apples. Yeah. Okay, I think this is good enough as a cover image already. Just need to find the right. Okay, let's just take a snapshot of this. Yeah, all right, so I need to upload Oh, I can upload gameplay video or trailer. Oh, I should do a stream where I do a gameplay video of this. But let's do the hard mode first, then I upload the video here. Yeah, that'll be great. That'll be great. So let's put cover image as this one first. Oh gosh, wrong. Upload cover image. Desktop. Can I upload more than one? Oh, if there's only one cover image, I'm gonna put a snake. Yeah, I want people to know this is like, there's a restricted visibility. Okay, so this one, screenshots. Okay, let's add screenshots to this. This one and this one. Since we can add one more screenshot, why not let's create one more screenshot. Oh, almost died there, almost died there. Not very nice. I like to. Yeah, okay, this is not too bad for a screenshot. Yeah, this will make for a good screenshot. Okay, let's go back to the. Public. Okay, so we save this, review the page now. Okay, where's my game? There we go. So I believe you can actually go to this link to play the game right now. Where's my Twitch stream? It's here. Yeah, please go ahead. You can play the game now, I guess. Yeah, it's already uploaded. It looks horrible though. It looks like such a huge waste of space at the side. And my snake light is like missing from here. Yeah, where's my snake light? The canvas is. Oh. I think it might be an issue with the canvas. I might need to re-upload this game. Yeah, I guess my snake light at the top is not appearing. Yeah. But I think you can already play this online already. Yeah. It's already uploaded on my itch.io. So yeah, look at that. How do you find it? Pretty cool, yeah. Pretty cool, yeah. Oh, that's great. Let's see if I can beat your high score of 31. All right, let's see. Yeah, it gets faster and faster. So. It's harder, but it also depends a bit on luck, because you have to see whether the rotten apples appear or not. There's a 10% chance of a rotten apple appearing. 31. Okay. 32. Let's see how much I can go. Where's the apple? Oh no, I was too greedy. Yeah, that was 36. Yeah, so I will have to add a high score feature here. Where you can, once you click on here, you can type in your name. Then we will send this high score to the firebase.io. Okay, then maybe you can click another button here for global high scores. Yeah, then I'm thinking whether I want to create this for mobile. So if I want to do for mobile, right, I will need to do an up, down, left, right button. Maybe somewhere here, up, down, left, right here that you can click with your fingers. And then here will be either press space slant touch to start. Yeah, so this will be some changes that we need to make. For now, I'm just curious why my score and high score appear so small here. Okay, so this is snake lights. Yeah, and I probably need to re-upload this. Yeah. Pretty cool, right? Okay, so okay, now I'm just curious, why does it look so different? See over here, this is like that. Oh, the scale is 2x. Oh no, this scale doesn't matter. It's weird because it's supposed to look the same as it does over here. Okay, let's unmaximize it. Right click. Here. Okay, so it must be something to do with this canvas. So screen space overlay. Okay, it's here, scale with screen size. At 960x600. So this should be scale with screen size here. Okay, then with this, then we can, okay, there's something wrong here. Okay, so if I do a scale with screen size, I think my snake might, but that's you the best. I'd like to just re-upload this again because I'm not very happy with the way my UI got butchered. So yeah, I'll probably re-upload this one and then I'll call it a day edit after I re-upload this new version of UI. And I think tomorrow I'll work on maybe having a high score. I think that's important because if not, there's no way we can compare who's the best, right? Yeah, so a global high score. Yeah, so I get the game minimally running first, then I will think about hard mode later. Yeah, so we get the game minimally running. Still thinking whether to make this game available for mobile users by adding some buttons. I mean, I could do it. I'm just thinking about the experience. Will the buttons be too small? Yeah. We need to plan the right size for the buttons. So yeah, now we just build the binary file again. Hopefully it is much faster. Yes, it's much faster now. Okay, so let's take a look at how it looks like. Awesome. Okay, so this has been loaded, I believe, into the, where's my finder? It probably, okay, also all these three screenshots, let me copy them, cut them, and then go to snake. Now I'll create a new folder called publicity photos. Then over here we just paste all the, oh okay, no big issues. I can just paste them from my desktop. I mean, I do have them on my desktop, so I can just put them in. Okay, then I have this webgl here that I need to delete. To delete this, let's just check. When was this built? Modified at 1020. Okay, this is correct. Quick action, compress. Yeah, we have to compress it. Okay, and then we go back to, let's edit this game. So, okay, I want to edit this. So edit game. Yep, I see you, go to Saba. I'm also gonna end soon. I just want to re-upload this and I'm done. Yep, you can let me know again what's your high score after you tried this game a few more times. Yep, see ya. Okay, let's see. Yeah, I want to upload my file. Snakes. Safe. And let's see how it looks like now. Yeah, it kind of like cut. It cuts off my top, right? Look at that. The snake light got cut off. Yeah. Not sure why this is done, but if I do a full screen, it's working. So I guess it's fine. I mean, no biggie. No biggie here. Just that. Yeah, I think it's working fine. So this is okay. Okay, I think I'm going to end my stream here. It's a bit late for me already. So yeah, quite happy with how the game turned out. Yeah, do check it out if you want to play it. And yeah, tomorrow I should be doing a high score table. Yeah, the Firebase. So yeah, stay tuned and yeah, see you around. Bye.